The other issue that I see a lot of guys having is they end up with knee problems on the side of their knee over here, especially as they're taking off into that rotation. What they're doing wrong is that they're instead of spinning their knee inward, yeah. What they're doing is locking their knee.
They're locking their
Can
knee,
you show right? us the right way and the wrong way okay, of keeping the knee soft versus keeping the knee locked? So show us the wrong way first.
Okay. So when a person, let's say a power puncher, let's say you get a hard power puncher, and he locks his leg because he feels like he's grounding himself. So he'll go, you know. He feels good because he has a lot of power. Maybe it worked for him in a couple fights, but he's like this. Now, the problem with that is eventually, say 12 rounds, 10 rounds, you're going to start getting, your body's going to fight against it itself because you're not smoothly, things are not going smooth. So then, to throw, let's say, a good power punch, let's say like the right hand that Mike Tyson hit Larry Holmes with, he turned into it. And it snapped. The whole body put the snap, and he can come back out just as easy. Therefore, less friction, more efficient, not winded because the whole body is automatic.
Can you show us that on the southpaw?
Southpaw.
So if we're doing it on the left side, right. The wrong way would be to lock the knee.
The wrong way is to
lock the knee. That is right. The wrong way, guys. What happens over here is the sciatic nerve, which comes off of the gluteus maximus, right over here in the hamstring, locks out right over here, right across as it splits off into the tibial nerve right behind your knee and the peroneal nerve right over here that gives power to the foot. When it's locked up like that, you're creating crazy amounts of neural tension, and that neural tension basically means it's like a rubber band. You're locking up the sciatic nerve. The sciatic nerve is the longest nerve in the body. It comes off your back, it goes down your leg. You can create disc herniations because you're snagging. If you think about it, you're literally snagging right over here as hard as you can, and that tethers. It's like tethering a rope. It's tethering the nerve up here, and what it does, it shuts off the glute. It literally shuts off your glute. Yeah. Your glute shuts off, it becomes inhibited, and guess what turns on? You're turning on your ITB, which is right over here. The ITB is a lateral side of your knee. The ITB is where that peroneal nerve dives underneath over here, and you get a pinch over there. I've seen a lot of boxers getting that. So if you're having pain in your knee and it hurts you when you're taking off on that last bit of your drive as you're about to let go of your punch, and it hurts you or when you're transitioning from positions, you're having that problem when you box mechanically, and you really need to soften up your knee. And there's a way we'll show you how to train that later, certain exercises that can retrain your glute to give you that whipping motion through external rotation and internal rotation. Great, thanks a lot. Mm-hmm.